19. Soak your prayer mat in wine. Being in constant communion with God, the saint alone can provide unfailing guidance and safeguard the disciple against various pitfalls along the way. The Dawn of Light. Khwaja Hafiz was a great saint of Persia, a seer gifted with the highest spiritual knowledge. On one occasion he said, "If your master so orders you, then dye your prayer mat in wine." When he uttered these words, there was a tremendous furor, because in the first place they were not in accordance with the Quran. This scripture strictly forbids the use of wine, which is abhorrent to all good Muslims. At the same time, a Muslim's prayer rug, or mat, is regarded as an extremely sacred and holy possession. To soak one's prayer mat in wine, therefore, would be an act of impiety that would be utterly unthinkable. What Hafiz had said was reported to the chief qazi, and Hafiz was ordered to appear before him. "You have committed blasphemy," said the qazi. "Either take back your words or justify your statement." "And what meaning do they have?" asked another qazi. "They are not in accordance with the Quran and make no sense whatever." "Do you see that hill?" Hafiz asked. "A fakir sits on top of it. Go to him. He will explain the meaning of my words." The qazi went over and climbed the hill. "Can you tell me the significance of the words that Hafiz has uttered?" he asked. "Oh, qazi," the fakir smiled and said, "please go to that town yonder and find a prostitute who lives there. The prostitute will explain the meaning of the words to you." This answer annoyed the qazi extremely, for he could not see what a prostitute might have to do with his question. But all the same, since he felt it his duty to inquire fully about the matter, he trudged into the nearby town and found the prostitute's house. When he arrived, it happened that the prostitute was not at home, and the housekeeper, believing him to be a wealthy client, asked a young girl in the house to serve as a substitute. This girl was one that the prostitute had purchased several years before, and who had only then come of age. Going to her, the housekeeper told her, "Since we have looked after you and brought you up with the greatest care, it is now your duty to join the profession for which we have prepared you." Accordingly, the girl was led to the room occupied by the qazi. The poor girl was much distressed, and tears rolled down her cheeks. Naturally enough, the qazi regarded such behavior as very unusual. "Why are you crying? Do you not live in this house?" he asked. "Oh, sir, I am one of the most unfortunate of all beings. Until this day I have lived a pure and pious life, and this is the first time that I am being forced into this evil act," the girl replied. "Where is your home? Can you remember the place you came from and who your parents were?" In reply, the girl told him, "When I was very young, some thieves raided one of the villages near where I lived. When I was running away from this danger, one of the thieves caught me. It was he who brought me to this town and sold me to the prostitute." When the girl gave him the name of her village, he recognized it as his own village. And when he asked the name of her parents, she turned out to be his own lost daughter. The qazi returned to the fakir. "I thought at first that you were simply sending me to a prostitute," he told him. "Perhaps, I thought, it is a joke of some kind. Who could tell? But my visit turned out to be the means by which I recovered my lost daughter." Again, the fakir smiled. "Now, O qazi, go back to Khwaja Hafiz and ask him to give you the next line of the couplet." In reply to the qazi's request, Khwaja Hafiz answered, "The true adept is not ignorant of the ways and secrets of the inner realm."